Bermuda 851, turn right, heading 180. Bermuda 14 Papa, turn right 245, report localizer established 27.
For the Boeing 747, the COVID-19 pandemic brought forward the inevitable, and that's been the mass retirement of the series around the world. We've seen major airlines like that of KLM, Qantas and British Airways, if not retire all their 747s, but the vast majority or a small amount. And that long list is now joined by Corsair, who retired their final 747 just days ago. It concludes what was a whopping 3 decades of the carrier flying the mighty Queen of the Skies. However, with the retirement of the Corsair 747, it also means that there are no more French carriers flying the Queen of the Skies. This is after Air France retired their very own 747 many years back. The retirement of the long-standing and iconic aircraft within an airline's fleet are usually met with a deep sadness but also celebration for the service it fulfilled and memories it helped make. Qantas hosted, as an example, a special flight from Melbourne to Sydney when they retired their final 767. It flew low over the city centre prior to it landing in Sydney, a fitting farewell. Given the COVID-19 pandemic, though, organising anything like a special flight for passengers on the final one was indeed written off. What pilots and ATC did organise, though, was a final low fly pass shortly after takeoff. In my opinion, this is definitely a fitting farewell for the Queen of the Skies, given the current circumstances. For Corsair, who, as mentioned earlier, have been operating the jet for decades, they were lucky enough to fly the 747-100s, 200s, 300s, 400s, and the 747-SP, just one of those, over the years. Their 747-100s were retired throughout the 1990s, while the -200s and -300s departed through the early 2000s. On more occasions than not, though, the Boeing 747-200s and 300s spent only a handful of years within the airline before being eventually scrapped. The -400s, which is the main variant in discussion for today's video, and of course at the moment is one of the only flying 747 variants alongside the 747-8, saw just 6 within the airline's fleet, with them arriving between 2005 and 2010. What you would expect, though, of an airline that isn't as big as, say, your Air France and KLM group, is that the retirements were very much spaced out for this aircraft, with no apparent structure for the retirement of the aircraft. Some went in 2012, another, say, went in 2014, 2015, and then we saw the last couple retired immediately following the COVID-19 pandemic. The CEO of the airline said, "So the 747 at Corsair was the aircraft of all, with the number of kilometres flown, flight hours, or the number of customers that we had the pleasure to carry. Today we open a new page of the airline's history and its future, built with a more modern, more efficient and more competitive fleet. It is also proof of our engagement to make more green and more environment friendly the aviation industry." Did you have the opportunity to fly with the 747 on this airline? Let me know, and as always, thanks for the support. See you all in the next video.